This is the previous generation Volkswagen Vento. To be honest, I didn't like it that much. But nowadays, the Vento has been selling more than our homegrown sedan, which is the Ciaz. This is the new Vento. And I gotta say, it looks pretty sprightly. At first glance, the changes are not that noticeable. But once you keep your eye set on this car, you can see the difference in the honeycomb grille, new bumpers, the metal grey, gunmetal grey rims, which are 10 spoke, which I really like, the new rear bumper, the side skirts, and the DRLs. The DRLs look so mean. I feel like it makes it look so much more aggressive and so much more interesting than the other drabby other car. On the inside, it's pretty much the same. There are a few updates, like the plastic is a bit more premium, the leathers are a bit more nicer, the DSG is pretty much the same. There is a new infotainment system which is pretty intuitive and quite easy to use, and nothing different from the other thing except that I can feel is the steering wheel's leather is very plush.
So driving the Vento feels plush. First impressions out of everything, it feels plush. It feels good. It feels very, very quiet. The engine doesn't make noise unless you're revving around 4,000 to 5,000 RPM, which does make a pretty good grunty noise. Take a listen. The engine feels pretty adequate for the car, but you do feel the weight. It has become heavier and heavier in every generation, which I'm pretty sure is because of all the extra accessories you get to put and all the gimmicks. But the engine feels good, it feels refined. The DSG is smooth as always. In the corners, there's a little bit of body roll, but it's because of the plush suspension. It feels very good. It's very confidence inspiring because I'm pretty sure I'm not going at a very high speed. But I can understand why someone would buy this over any other sedan, because it does so well in every other aspect. Rather than just comfort, it feels sporty. You get a sports mode, which I have just engaged. Let's see what it does. Pulling. Brakes can do with a little bit more of a bite. The engine is peppy. The engine is eager to rev. And it enjoys downblipping. It really enjoys downblipping. I'm not doing it. You can hear it. What I really wanted to show you was what a DSG can do. So a DSG is basically a synchronized clutch plate that has two clutches, which holds one gear above your current gear and one gear below your current gear. So if you're holding third gear, your DSG will be having fourth gear and second gear prepared. This creates quite a lot of speed quite fast, and it makes a car much faster than a manual. So what I want to do is I want to put that to the test. So what we're going to do is I'm going to pit this against the previous generation 1.6 TSI, which was the sportiest, fastest Vento you could find before. Whoa, good luck, we got one. Ready? three honks.
Ready?
And we're off. And we're beating him in first gear. So, no difficulty at all. And we're done. Smoking him. DSG, ladies and gentlemen, DSG. There was no competition. There was just no competition.
Huge thank you to B.U.Bhandari Wakad for lending us the car. Please like the video and subscribe to the channel. This is Bhavneet signing out.